What's up, YouTube? So I'm here on macOS Sierra, and I want to show you guys something pretty exciting. At least for me, it was. I found in the disk utilities here, and I know some other websites are reporting it now too, a RAID assistant. So RAID has finally returned to macOS where it lacked last year in El Capitan. Now, the reason this is important is RAID is really great for combining multiple drives. So as you see here, I have two USB 16 gigabyte flash drives, and with a RAID I could combine them. I could either make it so they duplicate themselves, so I have one 15 gigabyte drive and it's always duplicated onto another, or I could stripe them and make about a 30 gigabyte drive and have the speed be increased. So I'm going to show you guys how to do that in macOS Sierra here. So what you do is you open up your disk utilities and head to RAID, the RAID assistant. Now, the RAID I was talking about is called striped. Mirrored would be where it makes a duplicate one disk and then you have two copies. So, and then this one here, these are for other RAID sequences that when you get into a larger array of disks, it's becomes a little more complicated and you have to have X amount of disks. So with this tutorial, I'm just going to stick with the two main RAID partitions that you would probably use. So it's going to show me here the disks that I have available. I'm going to choose the two 15 or 16 gigabyte USB flash drives. And then all you have to do is create a name. So I could name it RAID. Before I do the RAID test, or before I do that, I just wanted to show you guys a quick speed test on the disk before and after. So if we can get speed test to open up here. And we'll just run a speed test on one of the drives. They're identical, so this one here. So we're getting about an average 18 to 20 read, or even drop it, or write, sorry, and we're dropping down on the write. And then the read's about 30 megabits, so that kind of flat line there. So this is probably not completely accurate, but just as an example. So we'll create the read. Hey Siri, say hello.
I can do that. Hello.
Goodbye, Siri.
Okay, see you later.
So once the RAID is complete, you can go done, and then you'll be brought back to the disk utility. And if you go to this new RAID partition here, you should see both disks. One of my disks isn't responding. So just give me a moment to fix that. And so now my RAID disk is up. It's kind of flaky with USB drives. What can I say? So with this, you can see I have 31 gigs now. So I have a 31 gig striped, so it'll write across both disks. Right here, you could add to the disk array, or you can remove a disk if you had more than two. If you remove the one, it's pointless. It's basically just what it would be. And then you can also run a repair, which this is very important because in El Capitan, you could have a disk array of, you know, and you could do it by terminal, but you couldn't actually repair the disks if something were to go wrong. You couldn't see which ones were online. So this really makes it easy to use. And then delete, of course, you can remove this RAID and get your drives back. You just have to reformat them. So one last thing, we'll just run a quick speed test across the new RAID and see how much faster it is using two drives instead of one drive. And we should see a bigger, or at least a better speed improvement. So you can see the read speed is a lot better. The write speeds in and out might be the USB drives. So there you have it. I did have a lot better results than that with this app, so you can see there the write speed's a lot higher. I think the application is just having a hard time measuring on being that it's not designed for being on the macOS Sierra. So anyways, guys, thanks for watching. Make sure you like this video, subscribe to the channel for more, and we'll see you again next time. Cheers.